have so many thoughts going through my head at a time like this, I have actually made notes so that I don't get confused and off track. There's a very full program, so I don't want to ramble too much. You know, the main thing I really wanted to say, because you're a captive audience, is thank you, really. Thank you all for entrusting your child's education to Cobblestone School. It's just wonderful to have your children in the school, and I know that often when you ask them, so what did you do today, you don't always get a full response. So here's a chance for you to see what your children have been doing musically during the rest of this year. And I will introduce both Charlotte and Joe to talk a little bit about the programs before the actual performances. But I also wanted to say that I realized that for some younger children, this might go a little past their bedtime. I hope you can all stay for the whole thing, because there is a grand finale for which everyone has practiced and in which everyone is included. And also, especially for parents of younger children, if you can stay for the whole thing, it's a chance for you to see your child's future. The older kids are really just a step or two or five ahead of the children who are just first or second year students here. And it's really great to see their development as they get older, and their just their sense of self-confidence and projections and the more sophisticated kinds of things that they can take on, the challenges that they can take on. So right now I'd like to introduce Charlotte Geibel to talk a little bit about the ORF program that is a weekly part of your children's schedule.
I'm very glad to have all of you here also, and it's really hard to know how to share what we do in a year, but we try to put something together, and I feel like what we're trying to do is expose our children to a variety of music from different cultures. You'll see that there are many different nationalities represented in the program tonight. Children hear music from other cultures and learn about other people that way. We also have music from other times and places that are part of our common cultural heritage, particularly as Western music. And so I've been trying to teach the children a little bit about a composer each month. The piece that they're going to march into at the beginning is by one of the composers we listened to this year very briefly, William Grant Still. We also did some music by Aaron Copland and by Haydn and by Brahms. So it's just good for them to start hearing music from other places. And of course, our pianist played our fiddle, gave us some more diversity in that. So it's good for us to keep broadening our taste. My goal is to help all the children start learning to hear music and understand it in their heads. And one of the ways to do that is to give them labels. So we talk about macro beats, right guys? And micro beats. Macro beats are the steady beat, and the micro beats are the divided beats, and sometimes they're in duple meter because they're in sets of two, and sometimes they're in triple meter because they're in sets of three. And those are really basic things to learn, but some of us never quite get labels on them, and then we don't notice them. One of the classes, Miss Barbie's class, is going to do a little dance to a piece that's combined meter. It's got triple and duple in the same. So that gives us something extra. We go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, like that. So that's what we're doing, in case you're wondering. And the instrumental parts are trying to go along with the melodies we have. So they might be just playing those macro beats, or they might be playing micro beats, or they might be playing a different melody on top of the melody we're singing. So I could go on and on, but I'll stop. And we'll let the children make some music.
I've got a big mouth, so I'm not going to lose the microphone. For those of you, my name is Joe. I teach kids in Bridget and Kelly's class. And I hope that they've been at home singing and singing and singing and driving you absolutely insane. Because that's what I told them to do. Not to drive you insane, but to sing and sing and sing. The insanity part is kind of a side effect. I don't teach music. What I teach is confidence. I teach kids to get outside of themselves, to take chances. Most of the kids, I'll be lucky if one of them is a rock star and sends me tickets one day to one of their concerts. But most of the kids, I just hope they enjoy music. But more than that, I hope they get, from the experience, the ability to say, you know what? I haven't done this before, but you know, maybe I'll give it a shot. And I think that's more important than whether they sing right notes or not. And I tell them it's really all about working together as a team. It's a group effort. I'm part of the group. I'm no more or less important than they are. They think I'm more important. The truth is, we work together as a team. And what you'll see today is teamwork. And kids who have worked extremely hard, all year long, they put their heart and soul into everything that they've done. So I'm going to go.
Yeah. Thank you.
give up my job. Don't want to do it, but you know, sometimes as a teacher you kind of have to do it. So I'm going to introduce you my assistant to Governor.
Thank you.
getting up and dancing?
Thank you.
teachers for a wonderful evening. I laughed, I cried, I thoroughly enjoyed myself. And our thanks are to Charlotte.